The last time a SpongeBob SquarePants movie was released was 10 years ago. It's true, it's 2015 now and that movie was in 2004, but that one was released in November and this one's released in February, so yeah. But I think this is a big deal because 10 years, and the SpongeBob SquarePants TV series has been on for 15 years. I used to be a big fan of it, and now a lot of new kids have taken my place. And even in high school, we still talk about a few episodes we remember. And I liked the 2004 movie, and I still do today. It's a nice guilty pleasure. So this is my thought on what the movie might be like from the trailers. So first, let's start off with what's good. I immediately liked the idea of the SpongeBob characters turning to 3D and getting out of the water. And I also like the dynamic about a book that can make anything you write in it come true. I think that will go good with kids. And the fact that SpongeBob is just, you know, a talking sponge out of water, something you don't see every day, and that he's communicating with everyone else that's normal or all around him. I think that the funniest thing a movie like this can do is for SpongeBob to unpurposefully scare someone, even though they're trying to be nice. I don't know, just when that happens in a live-action adaptation, I enjoy it. It's a reason I like cartoon adaptations. Going to 3D instead of just leaving it a 2D movie makes it, you know, a movie. It gives off a great opportunity, and I think that going this far is pretty neat. But here's what I think might be bad. I saw the first trailer from a friend on Facebook, and I said, no, but in a good way. I meant no as in, I can't wait for this. I can't believe they did that. But then when I saw the second trailer, it went a little downhill, because I didn't really know why there was a transition between regular Bikini Bottom and then a World War II Bikini Bottom. Just Squidward said, aren't you overreacting a little bit? I didn't know what they were overreacting about, but it was becoming very extreme, so yeah. Then in trailer 2, it introduced how Antonio Banderas' character takes the Krabby Patty secret formula in a way, and that is what causes the riot. I don't know, that just seems like an uninspired plot. I mean, yes, it's Krabby Patties and everyone loves Krabby Patties, but SpongeBob has made them billions of times. It's not like the secret formula being stolen could do that much. I feel that that's just an idea for a cartoon episode. If it had something else, like Banderas wanted all the characters to be executed and in a way they were, I think that would be good. And it's true. I know that this is supposed to be for kids, and I'm 16. It's for six-year-olds. But in the 2004 version, there's this giant cyclops that haunted me, who was really a diver, not a cyclops, but he was very big and very mean, and you get the idea. This villain seems a bit like a clown, in my opinion. Something that caught my attention was when SpongeBob's characters all grew these muscles and then acted like the Avengers, and some college girls had seen them. That was cool, but then there's a scene where that involves Patrick. And it involves window smashing and him holding two ice cream cones up. I knew what was going to happen, but I wish it didn't. It has an opportunity in that scene. And then it just resorts to being another joke that probably would never happen in real life, you know? I know that SpongeBob and the characters coming to life in real life would be a big thing, but I'm talking about the idea when in a situation that important. So basically, what I think is that kids are going to love it, and I might like it too if it ends up being a bit better than trailer 2. Guns N' Roses' Welcome to the Jungle is in the trailer, so I guess it's going to be played throughout the movie too. it, that song was released 13 years before the actual show started, so I think they're kind of showing kids what rock used to be, I suppose. So let's hope that they make up for its weird plot with that. So thanks, and if you see the sponge out of water, hope you like it.